coming out of these two than any actor that you would put in front of them. Because I know they're working off a script, they're gonna try to tell me what I think I wanna hear. These are real people that do this for a real job. And I think it's much better to use real people. Now, on the voiceover part, I don't see a problem with using professional voice for that. But you have to remember, it's also good in your business to get your face and the sound of your voice and everything out in front of people. I mean, that's who you guys are. So to have your picture there and to have your voice and all, I don't think is a bad thing on your listings.
I guess my other question is, how does this work into the show? Like, somebody calls in, are they going to call about a particular listing? Are they going to, it's just a general question, and then we show these.
Yeah, I mean, it is formatted.
Okay.
You know, in segments.
It's not like somebody calls up and say, I'd like to, y'all look at MLS 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you've got to, okay.
No, it's very formatted, very structured, very segmented.
And also, for everyone's listening, I put your cell phone number, or it didn't go to the office.
Right,
when you paid that $25 for your listing to be there, that lead goes straight to you, not to the office.
Well, I like what Gail said about the green room effect. Just for the simple fact that if it's your listings, your sellers are seeing you trying to sell their listing versus them saying, well, why do you have another girl to advertise in my property?
Well, and it had your picture. Right. That's the way we formatted it, was that it was
showing. You can outside the box for maybe the next time or two or something like that.
Well,
yeah.
And that's what we're looking for is, do we have the money to do the next time?
Gentlemen,
all right, Scott, the website's Waymore FM, right?
Yes.
Okay, so how will they know to go to Waymore FM to look at all this stuff? What's the reference to Waymore FM?
Well, we are doing a lot of social media marketing for the Waymore FM, and what we do in that is we will say, you know, visit these programs. We also have been running a lot of promotional spots for you guys on there as well. And we advertise in Dockline and Splash and North of the Border and different things like that that are driving people to the website. And once you get to the website, then we try to, you know, get you going to the programs once you get there as well. So a lot of internal marketing and some external stuff as well. Like I say, I was pretty amazed to have 36,000 listeners in just 3 months. I mean, that kind of shocked even me, to be honest. You know, I say that with pride, but I didn't know we could get those kind of numbers that quick, to be honest.
Do we know what the numbers are for each segment that you have? Like, you have a real estate segment, then you have a...
Yeah, I do have all that broken down. That's the other thing that's great about the internet is it's very trackable. I can tell how many people watched your program. I can tell how many people, when they came in, when they left. You know, if they came in and watched 2 minutes and left, or if they watched the whole program. I can tell you what areas they came from, you know, if they were all from this area, or if they were spread out. You know, that's a great thing about the internet is it's very trackable. Some cases I can even tell you know, the computer they were watching it from, but at least, yeah, I know. But at least I can tell you the area, like Consolidated provided them with their internet provider, or Suddenlink, or somebody like that, so that we can target it down to pretty close to the areas that they're watching.
So if you're interested, sign the sheet.
Anything else? Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you you know, kind of share with other people to make their job easier, and so that you can learn and make your job easier. You don't have to participate. Okay, so if you're new and you don't really have anything that you know, just come and learn. Come and learn from the other people in here. So I'm gonna pass this around. If you haven't, leave it at the front desk, but we got about 30 people signed up so far. We do need to give them a head count today because they're preparing breakfast. It's $10. If you bring a guest from another company or someone thinking about getting into real estate, both you and your guest are free. Okay, so I encourage you to come that on Thursday. Friday, Mike's class. Mike, I saw him walk in a few minutes ago. You still in here?
Yeah.
What are you going to do this week?
Fusion with the new agents.
Okay, Fusion.
What about Fusion Bay?
And then at noon, Matt's Brown Bag Lunch Bunch. Okay, because the class last week went a little bit longer, we're going to do the lunch bunch. The session one is going to be this week at noon to 1.
February 1st.
Can I talk about the Fusion class?
Yeah.
Just to keep the confusion down on the Fusion. Everybody should have gotten an email from me about the Fusion class on February 1st. We've had some little bit of clarification. It is definitely on. It's going to be an April sound. Marilyn, can't remember her last name, from HAR is going to teach the class. So it's going to be a 3-hour, exactly what you would get over at HAR. We cannot invite guests because at this point I've got 50 people already signed up, and that's just KW. If you have not signed up, reply back to that email because I've got a spreadsheet working to make sure that we give a head count to April Sound for food. Because we're going to be there at 8:30 in the morning, eat, and then dive right into the Fusion class. It's $10, and it's well worth $10. That, or you can go down to Montgomery County HAR and have fun with all those people. But I'd rather have the family.
Yeah. Gail also MCE.
And it is an MCE credit for 3 hours.
Gail,
cool. February 1st.
Yeah, and mine's nothing like mine is. I'm a freshman coach. This is just.
Are you taking the verification class?
I am going to take it, but I haven't yet.
I'm in. Okay.
Juan's going to help me. Juan's taking water classes.
You can bring your laptops. I think they've got plenty of internet speed there, April 10th. If it does get a little slow there, y'all just follow along and take notes. That's all I can promise.
They don't have a lot of power, though.
She said that they're going to have a projector. Marilyn's going to have all the stuff.
He needs power strips. So charge your computer, right?
Computers, yeah.
Charge your laptops before you come.
It should be a good class for $10, 3-hour MCE, and you're earning something that you've got to learn anyway because tempo is going away. Mm-hmm. Fusion is taking its place. So,
if you want to have an open house this weekend, get with Jessica at the front desk, or if you have a house you want held open. And then Monday, Bold Plus from 9 to 10, and from 1 to 2, Monday Mojo with Ruth.
Hey, Ruth said to tell you that that's going to be how to become debt-free in 6 to 10 years on that Monday Mojo.
Okay, so in 6 to 10 years, be here Monday. Okay, upcoming events. Technology Mastermind, we've already talked about that. From noon until 1:30 on the 20th will be January Celebration Day. And I've asked Jim to tell you a little bit about what we're going to do. There, so Jim, why don't you stand up and tell a little bit about how we're going to do this.
All right, guys. I mean, I know y'all have all been to fundraisers and stuff and seen silent auctions. My idea we came up with to maybe generate some money for Keller Williams Cares and put some money back in your pocket. So if you got a Christmas gift that you don't want, you got a nearly new item that you bought, not going to use, you know, bring up some old sneakers or something. A minimum of 25% of it will go to Keller Williams Cares. In other words, you got a $100 item that's retail, you say, okay, bring it up front to either Jessica or go ahead and talk to them about that. We're going to bring them in. You'll have a check-in sheet. It's a two-part deal. You'll get a receipt saying, this is what I dropped off. You need to put a minimum bid on there. Don't put $99 on a $100 item. I mean, put something realistic. I mean, $75 at the very least, or maybe $50 would be a good place to start on a minimum bid. Say somebody bids up to $100 on it. You're going to get $75, Keller Williams Cares is going to get $25. We're all going to have a lot of fun with it. There'll be tables out here, it'll be lined up, and you'll just go and bid on the items. And you're not restricted to 25%. If you've got an item, you said, hey, I'd just like to donate this to Keller Williams Cares, put it out there, it'll be on the sheet, how much you're donating back, and it might influence, you know, what somebody pays for the item, if they think it's all going to charity or whatever. But anyway, just something to have fun at celebration day. No clothes. Unless it's something like a real nice, something you ladies might like or something. I'm not going to bring a sports coat or anything up here, but really like no clothes, meaning a new purse or wallet or something like that. Some kind of accessories, like from Greg's store, Accents and Accessories. Jewelry, watches, a briefcase, cameras, GPS, electronics, any of that kind of stuff. But we don't want a $500 item up here, but you never know, so.
We don't want $5 items either.
You don't want $5 items either, because we've got a limited amount of spaces. And we were going to limit to like 3 per person, but I mean, we don't know how this is going to go, so it's only going to be as good as what y'all put into it. And so I know everybody's got 1 or 2 items that are up in the closet or in a drawer or something like that that you're not going to use, that you say, hey, man, if I can get, you know, $50 and Keller Williams Cares get $75, then that's great. So any questions on how this works?
What day is
that? It's at Celebration Day.
31st.
Oh,
okay.
No,
20th.
The
20th. So we'll have a deadline. What we're going to do is we're going to send out an email with these instructions, kind of, and it'll also be your sheet that you'll turn in. You'll go ahead and fill it out and then bring it up here, and if you don't have one, we'll have them at the front. You don't have to print it out if you don't want to, but just for your convenience, if you want to print it out ahead of time and bring it in. Bring your items up and let's have fun and put some cash in our pockets and raise money for Keller Williams Cares.
Thanks, Jim. All right. Also, this next thing I'm passing around is the Celebration Day sign-up. So, again, we are having lunch, potluck, like normal. We are celebrating January birthdays, December awards, and Chinese New Year. So we're celebrating Asian food. So you'll pass it around, sign up if you haven't already. And then on the 31st, we are having our annual awards banquet. We are actually having this one at April Sound Country Club this year. We grew the place where we had it last year, so I know it's back to back there. A lot of things there, but they give us a pretty good deal. So 9 to 11, might be a good idea to get there a few minutes before. But Wes is going to be sending out an email with the people and where you stood in awards. So make sure you double check those emails and get back to them, please. So we can make sure we have everything accurate for our awards. Texas Homeland, David.
Somehow I ended up with this sheet. This is the sign up for Tech Mastermind on Thursday. Did y'all get it over here? Here, how about the
back we'll leave that in front.
Somebody sent in a question. I'm going to be very brief because I know we're running late. Somebody sent in a question. Ask David. Yes, well, let me just announce a big, humongous announcement. In like 3 weeks from today, there's going to be a very special guest up here. 2 weeks from today? Yes, 2 weeks from today. A very special guest up here who is extremely knowledgeable in all matters title. So you'll want to be here and not miss and not miss this. I promise you it will be very, very impressive. Somebody sent this question in to Andrew over the website, right? Over the internet somehow, and they wanted to know, can a person who's incarcerated own property, or purchase property rather? And so the answer to the question is yes. A person who's incarcerated can purchase property. They can sell property as well. Might be hard for them to get a loan. I guess, Rich, would you guys give an incarcerated person a loan?
We love incarcerated.
Yeah. Because they make so much money every day that they can pay their loans back. 42 cents a day income.
Is good. You will go to prison if that's
yeah. Take an ass.
But basically, we can go to the prison and we send a notary up there to the prison to go in and meet with them and sign documents. Rarely is it to purchase, but technically, legally, a prisoner can purchase property. But most of the time, it's to sell property, which is why we go up there. So I knew many of you were dealing with prisoners. As your would really be interested in knowing. So I thought maybe we had some of the Huntsville people over here. Or I figured, Andrew and I figured that.